Automatic motorbike systems work differently with manual motorcycles. On the automatic motor, there is a CVT that drives the motor. With this system, the motor can perform full automatic speed shifts according to engine speed. Inside the CVT, there are two front and rear pulleys connected by a V-belt. The front pulley is connected to the crankshaft, while the rear pulley is related to the final gear directly to the rear wheel. The two pulleys can widen and shrink so that they will push the belt outward. The widening and shrinking of the rear pulley depends on the pull of the front pulley. When the engine is rotating at low speed, the turning power from the crankshaft is forwarded to the front pulley, to the V-belt, to the rear pulley and centrifugal clutch. If the rotary power is not sufficient, the centrifugal clutch will not expand. Because the tensile force on the clutch is still stronger than the centrifugal force, so the centrifugal clutch does not touch the clutch housing. As a result, the rear wheels also don't spin. As engine speed increases, the centrifugal force will be stronger compared to the spring pull, resulting in the clutch shoes starting to touch the clutch house and starting with friction. In this condition, V-belt at the front pulley at the inner diameter position, small, and at the rear pulley at the large outside position. So as to produce a large rotation, torque causes the rear wheels to spin easily. Medium rotation: when the engine speed increases, the ballast or roller on the front pulley starts to move out because of the centrifugal force, and presses the primary sliding sheave or shiftable disc pulley towards the fixed sheave or the silent pulley disc, and compressing the outer circumference V-belt of the primary pulley, thereby making the diameter of the primary pulley enlarge and pulling the secondary pulley to a smaller diameter. At high rotation, the compressive force of the roller increases, so that the V-belt is increasingly pressed to the outer side of the primary pulley so that the diameter increases, and the diameter of the secondary pulley gets smaller. The next one will result in a higher ratio of rotation. If the secondary pulley plate is widened, the diameter of the V-belt on the pulley will be smaller, so that the ratio of rotation will increase.